Well, we keep hearing this monster El Nino is taking aim for California with a steady stream of powerful storms. But most people want to know, when are those storms going to hit? KCAL9's Erica Nochlin is live in Pasadena, where there was an El Nino forum tonight where experts did some myth busting. So, Erica, tell us what you found out tonight.
Well, Elsa, El Nino is technically already here, but the expert we heard from tonight says all of the effects of El Nino, like the rain and the flooding, those are coming very soon.
What I call the Godzilla El Nino. And so all I have to say about that is yikes.
He's the guy who coined the term Godzilla El Nino in the winter of 97 and 98. Remember that? Well, now NASA scientist Bill Patzert says Godzilla is coming for California again.
As you can see, it is a monster.
He showed a crowd in Pasadena what El Nino looked like in 97 and now. He points out 2015 looks even a bit larger.
It's eerie how similar in size and intensity this El Nino is with the El Nino of 18 years ago. So I think we can expect at least the same impacts.
But when?
Everybody's impatient here in California. Where's the El Nino? Sit tight. In January and February, you'll essentially be riding your kayak in front of your home.
But he says the flooding won't end the drought, even though new images show more snow in the Sierras this November compared to last November. Patzert warned it's simply not enough. So he says don't stop conserving water. But do prepare for the rain with emergency supplies and flood insurance. That's why all these people are here. They're trying to avoid the 17 deaths and $500 million in damage California experienced in the winter of 98.
We can minimize that if we get prepared.
Bill Patzert is even preparing with jokes.
At this point, if it doesn't arrive, I'm going to have to go into witness protection.
So just because El Nino is the most intense on record this year doesn't mean the actual rain and storms will be all that strong. It just means they're going to be steady, consecutive, one right after the other. Elsa and Susie, back to you.
You know, Erica, we're usually worried about earthquake insurance and what we need for earthquakes. You mentioned flood insurance and emergency supplies. Is there anything else people should keep in mind?
Oh, absolutely. There are a ton of things to research, but some of the things that stood out tonight are to trim your trees. That's going to be a big deal because the drought has made trees a lot weaker right now. Also, if you have emergency supply water on the ground, maybe in your garage, put it up on a shelf because if floodwaters start to pour in, it's going to contaminate that water. Back to you.
All right, Erica Nochlin live in Pasadena for us tonight. Thank you for those tips.